Defining a static named query via the named query annotation is the most common way in JPA. It has the main advantage that the persistence provider can compile and validate the query at startup time. But you also have to define the query statically at compile time. Okay, you can still define a dynamic query at runtime, but how do you handle all the queries that can't be defined at compile time, but are static as soon as the application gets started, or any other point in time? In these cases, you can use the programmatic definition of a named query, which was introduced in JPA 2.1. By doing this, you can define or change a named query and most of its settings at runtime. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. If you want to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you learned something new. That helps me reach a broader audience. There are three steps you need to do to create a named query at runtime. And these steps are, first, create a query. This can be done as a JPQL, native, or criteria query. You can also define additional hints and settings for the query. Second, find a name for your query that is unique within your persistence unit. If there's already a named query defined for the name, the query will be updated. And third, use the query and name to call the addNamedQuery method on the Entity Manager factory. Let me show you how to define a simple named query and how to specify additional settings for a query in the IDE. The following code snippet shows how to create a simple named query which selects all authors who have written a book with a title that contains a specific string. As you can see, the query looks similar to a query that you provide in a named query annotation. It defines a JPQL query and uses a named query parameter. Setting the parameter value is not part of the definition. The named query is called in the same way as any other query defined by a named query annotation. The createNameQuery method is called with the name of the query, the required parameters are set by calling the setParameter method, and the result of the query is requested by calling the getResultList method. A named query can define more than just the query string. Any configuration of the query except the parameter binding will be part of the named query. You can, for example, define an SQL result set mapping or an entity graph that shall be used when executing the named query. In the following code snippet, I create a named query based on a native SQL statement, specify a SQL result set mapping that maps the query result into a POJO, and limit the result to the first 5 records. You can call this named query in the same way as the previous example. You call the createNameQuery method of the entity manager to create the query and call the getResultList method to send it to the database and get the result. The programmatic definition of a named query can be useful if it can't be statically defined at compile time, but will not change after the application startup or any other given point in time. This can be done via the addNameQuery method of the Entity Manager factory, which creates a named query based on a query object with all its settings except the actual parameter bindings. The named query is used in the same way as any other named query defined by a named query annotation. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content like cheat sheets and ebooks about some of JPA's and Hibernate's most interesting features. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!